Hello guys, welcome to my channel HPI Tutorials. In this video, we will discuss about how we can highlight the web elements using JavaScript Executor in Selenium WebDriver. So generally, while performing the testing, we get the requirements like we want to capture the screenshot by highlighting the elements, right? So even in test automation also, we get the requirements for this. Like we want to capture the screenshot in every verification step. So generally a test case includes so many verification steps, right? So in the verification step, I want to highlight the verification part, whatever I'm verifying that I want to highlight, then I want to capture the screenshot. So that screenshot I will be including in my either report or it might be my test repository or wherever it is. Okay. But I want to highlight the element, then capture the screenshot. So that's my requirement. Okay. So in these kind of scenarios, how you are going to do? Basically, the Selenium WebDriver can capture the screenshots, but it cannot highlight the elements, right? So there is no method for highlighting the elements and then capture the screenshot. Or at least there is no method for highlighting the web elements, right? So in these scenarios, how you are going to perform them? So we are going to take the help of JavaScript and we will perform the operations, okay? So in this video, we will see how we can do that. So let me open my Eclipse. So here I have one class file that is JS Executor Demo. So this class file I'm going to use for practice today. So here I have added the code for launching Chrome browser and then it will navigate to Facebook homepage. Okay, I mean login page. So let me just open the Chrome. So here you can see the Facebook login page. So in this page, for example, I want to highlight this email text box. Okay, or I want to highlight this one. Facebook helps you connect this text. Okay. So in that case, how I can do that? So let's see. I'll just press F12. I'll open the developer tools. I'll inspect this one. Okay. So I want to highlight this element, this text box. So here basically we can highlight the element in two ways. One is we can find the element also in the JavaScript and highlight the element in the JavaScript. And in the second way, if you already find the element in the web driver, you can highlight that element using JavaScript. In the second scenario, we are not actually finding the element from JavaScript. We are simply highlighting the element which is already found in the web driver. Okay. So I will show you both the things. So first let me copy the email and I'll go to console. So here I'll write the JavaScript basically. So here even for highlighting also, we have two options. One is you can simply highlight by changing the border, or you can highlight by changing the border and background also. So let me show you both the things here. Okay. So first I will change the border only, then I will change the border and background also. So here I'll write document.getElementById. I want to highlight this one, right? Email text box. So the ID is email dot. I'm going to change the style. Okay. Basically, if you are changing any border or background, they are the styles for this element, right? So in HTML, if you are adding any color, that comes under style only, right? So here I'm changing the style. Style dot. First, let me change the border. Okay. Equal. I'm going to pass a 2 pixel solid line with a red color. Okay. So let me just execute this. Now you see this text box got a red color border. So it is highlighted, right? So you can do highlight by simply changing the border also. Okay. And in the second scenario, you can change the border as well as you can highlight this element by changing the background to yellow. So generally the highlighter will be in the yellow color, right? So I will do that one also. Document dot get element by ID. Style dot background. Okay. So here you can provide the color whatever you wish to. So I am giving yellow. Now you see the border is already changed and now it changed the background also. So in these two options, you can choose any option whichever is like to you. The first option is simply by changing the border, and the second option is change the border as well as background. So here, so if you are changing simply a border, this one is enough. Okay, it is a one line statement, right? So this will do. But if you want to change both the things, you need to write two lines, right? So let me just simplify that. So here, document dot get element by ID, email. So here we are changing the single attribute values like border or background. So what I will do, I will use set attribute method, which allows me to change the multiple attribute values. Okay. So here the attribute is style. So if you apply any style, it will come under style attribute only, right? So for the style attribute, I'm going to change the value. So the values are first border 2 pixel solid red, then background is yellow. So here you can provide multiple attribute values. Okay, so this is the attribute name and this is the value for that one. In the style also, you have so many attributes like border, background, foreground color, font size, like that you have so many things. If you want to provide multiple things here, you need to use semicolon. For providing the value for one attribute, you need to use colon. Okay. So now if you see, I have two attribute pairs. Okay. I have separated them using semicolon. So now actually this is already highlighted, right? So first let me copy this. I'll refresh the page. So now the highlighting is gone. Okay. So let me run this one. Okay, I just missed this one, closing braces. Okay. So now you see it is highlighted with border as well as background. So now this is a single line, right? So if you want to perform the second operation, that is changing the background and border, you can use this line. Okay. If you want to perform only changing the border, from this also you can do. Okay. You can simply remove this one, the background yellow. So let me do this from Selenium WebDriver. So if you want to perform any JavaScript related actions from Selenium WebDriver, we need to use JavaScript Executor. So this JavaScript Executor is an interface. Okay. So if you want to know more about this JavaScript Executor, like what is this JavaScript Executor and how we use this and why we need to actually use it and what is the syntax and everything, you can click on this link to watch my previous video. In that I have explained everything very clearly. Okay. So first let me create the JavaScript executor reference. So I will say JS executor. So I'll just provide the casting. So now the reference is created. Okay. So let me use the reference and I will call execute script method. Okay. So here I will provide the JavaScript. So first let me provide the complete thing. Okay. So I want to highlight this element only. So I'll just pass the entire thing. And here I am identifying the element also in the JavaScript only, right? So I'm not passing any arguments basically here. So I'll just remove the arguments and I'll close this. Okay. So now let me run this. See, the JavaScript is executed and it highlighted the element also. It took some time because I have provided some thread.sleep here. Okay. So I'll just comment this one for next run. So now this one is completed, right? So let me just show you with a single border only. I'm just removing this background. Okay. So I'll remove this also. Okay. So let me run this. Now it should open the Facebook homepage, I mean the login page, and it should highlight that email text box with only border because I am not providing the background here. Okay. See, the border is changed to red color, right? So Let me keep the both the things. Okay. Here I have identified the element in the JavaScript, right? So let me identify the element in the web driver. So here I will write web element, because after finding the element, I want to store that element, right? So I'll say email txt. Okay. Driver dot find element by ID, and the ID is email, right? So I will use the same syntax. So here, instead of this one, I'm going to replace it with arguments of 0. Nothing changes. This one is exactly same, but only the arguments is added. Okay. So here I need to provide the argument. The argument is the email text box, right? So let me run this. So this time we are finding the element in the web driver and highlighting in the JavaScript. See, it is highlighted. It changed the border and background also. So for example, you want to highlight the element, then you want to simply remove the highlighting. Okay. Just for 2 seconds, you want to highlight. It's like, you know, a flash kind of thing. You want to simply highlight for 2 seconds, then remove the things. So in that case, what you can do, you can use the same syntax, but you can simply remove the style. Okay. So here I'm not providing any border, as well as I'm not providing any background also. So let me run this. I'll first highlight this one, then I will keep it like this for 2 seconds. Okay. So let me run this. Now you see the border is removed and the background also removed, right? So this way you can simply highlight and then remove the highlighting. So this is how we basically apply the highlighting. Okay. So we are simply changing the attribute values in the DOM and we highlight the elements. Okay. So it's up to you. Like if you want to keep the highlighting like that and then capture the screenshot and continue to the next script or something, then you can do that. Or if you want to simply highlight the element and then after some time, if you want to remove that highlighting, you can use this. Okay. So yeah, I hope you understand this session. If you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.